Hi students, welcome back. Today we will study about centripetal and centrifugal forces. In this video, we will see how centripetal force works, then how centrifugal force acts on each body, and then we will study the difference between these two forces. I would recommend you to watch my previous video on uniform motion to get a clear idea on circular motion. So let's start. Center seeking force or centripetal force. To understand centripetal force, let's imagine you have a ball attached to a string and you start to swing it in circles. If you look carefully, how does it work? Because in this example, you will know how actually centripetal force works. We all know about Newton's second law of motion, which tells us that force acting on a body in a straight line is equal to mass into acceleration. So, if there is an acceleration produced, means there is a force involved with it. Suppose a body travels in a circular path as shown in this figure. Then what happens? Its velocity at this point is here, and the velocity constantly changes at each point. And as we can see here, the net force acts towards the center of the circle. Since the velocity changes at each point in a circular path, velocity changes means there is a change in acceleration. What is acceleration? Acceleration is change in velocity per time. So in a circular path, there is an acceleration produced. Why? Because the velocity changes at each point, as we can see here. The velocity is changing at each point, the velocity changes. And since the velocity changes, there is an acceleration involved. And wherever an acceleration involved means force is equal to mass into acceleration. So acceleration produced means there is a force. And here the force acts towards the center of the circular path. The force and the velocity are always perpendicular to each other, as you can see in this figure. Now suppose this force, which is directed towards the center of the circle, is known as centripetal force or center seeking force. Suppose, now let's say we know that second law says that the net force acting on the body is called centripetal force, which acts in a circular path, and the acceleration produced is known as centripetal acceleration. The ball has a tangential velocity. We have already seen that. If you suddenly cut the string, the ball will fly off in whatever the tangential direction was at the moment you cut. Let's see here. Suppose the force is always directed toward the center, and if we cut, the ball flies in the tangential direction. At that point, the centripetal force acting on the ball is constantly directing the ball towards the center of the circle or your hand. This, combined with the ball's velocity, keeps the ball swinging in the circle. Now, the same centripetal force that keeps the ball swinging in the circle also keeps the roller coaster on the track. So this is how centripetal force works. Now, what are the main points of centripetal force? First, acceleration is caused by a force. Then force must be in the same direction as the acceleration, and it's always towards the center of the circle. Centripetal force acts towards the center of the circle. Then centripetal force is provided by some external force, that is friction. When you started to roll it with your hand or swing it with your hand, then only the centripetal force is created. So it is due to some external force such as provided by friction. The examples of centripetal force are shown in the figure given below. First, this one is an atom. An electron moves around the nucleus in a circular path for which centripetal force is obtained. The electrostatic force of attraction on the negatively charged electron by the positively charged nucleus. Similarly, in this example, the planet moves around the sun in nearly circular path for which gravitational force of attraction on the planet by the sun provides the necessary centripetal force. We all know that centripetal force is provided by an external force. Yet the gravitational force provides the centripetal force. Similarly, a moon revolves around the earth in a circular path. That is also an example of centripetal force. In all these examples of centripetal force, the body moves in a circular path with constant speed under dynamic equilibrium. So this is how centripetal force works. The formula for centripetal force. The acceleration or centripetal acceleration is equal to velocity square by radius. And this velocity is tangential to the circular path. So putting this formula in the place of acceleration, what we will get? Force is equal to mv square by r. So this is how we can calculate the centripetal force. Now what is law of inertia? We all know the Newton's first law of motion. What does it state? A body continues to be in state of rest or in motion unless and until a force is applied on it. As you can see in this example, suppose, let's say you are riding in a car or a bike. You are moving at a constant speed, but when you stop, your body leans forward. When you begin to move again, your body will lean backward. This is called inertia, which is the tendency of an object to resist the state of rest or motion. Similarly here, when the driver turns towards in a circular path, if a body moves in a circular path and the driver tries to turn in a circular path, what will happen? You will see that your body turns away from the circular path. This is also due to inertia. Now what is centrifugal force? Centrifugal force is an imaginary force which can be described as a tendency of an object following a curved path to fly outward from the center of the circle. It's not a really force. It results from inertia. That is the tendency of an object to resist any change in its state of rest or motion. Now let's see this video so that you can have a better and clear knowledge of centrifugal force. Imagine you are sitting on a merry-go-round. So as you spin, you might feel as though you could be pulled right out of your seat. What causes this feeling of being pushed outward? The answer is centrifugal force. Just as objects are in motion, are subject to the properties of resisting motion and rest with inertia, they also want to move in a straight line as possible. What happens? Any object will try to move in a straight line as possible. So let's see this. Sometimes if an object cannot move in a straight line, so it moves in the straightest line it can go through. Think of a ball attached to a string. When a force is applied to the ball, it tries to move in a straight line. But if it can't, because it's pulled by the string, and when we have cut in the case of centripetal force, it flows in the tangential or the straightest way it can go through. Just remember that centrifugal force is due to the inertia, and the body will always strive to find the straightest way possible. Now, let's see this one. What happens? The person inside falls out or falls outward. That is centrifugal force. Let's say this is a stationary platform. And suppose let me give an axis, coordinate axis, imaginary coordinate axis, such as X and Y attached to the stationary platform. The train is said to be relative to the stationary platform. The system of imaginary coordinate axis attached to such a stationary platform is called inertial frame of reference. Watch these two trains traveling with the same uniform velocity adjacent to each other. An observer sitting in one of the train will not be able to detect the motion of the other train. So the imaginary coordinate axis attached to one of the train will behave identical to the one attached to the stationary platform. Newton's law can be safely applied to this frame of reference with uniform motion. An imaginary coordinate system which is either at rest or in uniform motion when Newton's law are valid is called inertial frame of reference. Now let's consider this one. Suppose this person is inside a merry-go-round or a rotating frame and there is a wooden block placed inside this rotating frame. What will this person observe? He will observe that a radially outward force, as you can see, it's marked outward from the center, that is called centrifugal force, acts on the block according to the observer, is a real force only in his own rotating frame of reference. The person, as we have already seen the previous part of the video, where the person or the boy inside the merry-go-round was pushed outward out of the circular path. So the person here, imagine that same person inside this merry-go-round will feel as if the force is acting such as it's pushing out this wooden block outside this rotating frame. Now what happens? He feels that there is a force acting on the wooden block and it is allowing the wooden block to go outside, outward to the center. But a person, for an observer standing outside the rotating platform, the centrifugal force is a pseudo force. He cannot feel any force. Or the person who was standing outside the merry-go-round cannot feel any force. So for him, there is no force acting here. But for the person inside this rotating frame, he can feel the force as if it is acting on him or it's outward or putting the wooden block out. So the centrifugal force is a pseudo force in an inertial frame of reference. The radially outward force on a body in uniform circular motion observable only in a rotating frame of reference is called centrifugal force. Centripetal force is what? Which acts towards the circle, and centrifugal acts outward from the center to the circumference. The magnitude is same for both centrifugal and centripetal, and it's mv square by r. Pseudo forces appear only in accelerated or non-inertial frame of reference. For him only there is a force. So this is how they act. Similarly, if a car is moving in a circular path, and what happens? This person feels a force which is radially outward, directed outward. This is centrifugal force. The force developed in a rotating body because of which the body tends to move away from the center along the radius is a centrifugal force. Also acts normal to the direction of motion of a body but radially outward from the center along the radius. And one more thing, it is only observable for the person inside the rotating frame of reference. The person outside cannot observe this centrifugal force. So the centrifugal force is not a real force. It's a pseudo force which is observable only inside a rotating frame. Hope you have understood that centrifugal force. Now what is the difference between this centripetal and centrifugal force? First, centripetal force is that which keeps an object moving uniform speed along a circular path. And it's always directed towards the center. This is the tendency of an object following a curved path to fly away from the center of curvature. And how it is? The direction is along the radius of circle from the center towards the object. Then example for centripetal is satellite orbiting a planet. What happens for centrifugal force? Mud flying off a tire. Then children are pushed out of a merry-go-round. This is an example of centrifugal force. Formula is same, but centripetal force is a real force and centrifugal force is not a real force. It is just due to inertia of motion. This was defined by Isaac Newton and centrifugal force was defined by Christian Huygens. So this is how centripetal and centrifugal force work. Hope you have understood. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. And if you have understood the concept, please like my video and subscribe to my channel for more updates.